Welcome to MarcusG.TV. I am Chef Marcus Giuliano, and I'm a chef on a mission. This is also Chef on a Mission Radio, affiliated with Aroma Time Radio. I want to talk about frozen fish. Many chefs, especially consumers, are really anti-frozen fish. There are certain vendors that are really pushing and have been pushing frozen fish for the last 10 years, but as a whole, when consumers go to retail outlets like the grocery store and they see previously frozen, or they see something in the frozen aisle, in the frozen bins for seafood, it's a turnoff to a lot of consumers still. And at the restaurant, at my restaurant, people ask, well, is this fresh or is it frozen? Like frozen is something bad. Sea to Table, which is a phenomenal company, just sent out a great email on why fresh may be best, or why frozen is best. Sea to Table, a great small seafood company, just sent out an email stating frozen can be fresher than fresh, and I've always said that. And they go in this great email and explaining that for the longest time, frozen fish was a dirty word. It used to be when the fishmonger couldn't sell his fish. You know, the fish is sitting there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. By the time Friday comes around, the fishmonger would freeze it in his own freezer. So here's the big difference. Well, here's the first point I want to make. The average time that it takes for fish to be caught and delivered to your plate, whether you're in a restaurant or a grocery store, is about 6 to 7 days. Now, 6 to 7 days is a lot of time for microbial growth. So if you freeze fish when it's caught, as soon as it's caught, within hours, within the day that it's caught, what happens is you stop that microbial growth. Now, the difference between the freezer that you're going to have at home and your average fishmonger, your retail outlet, is these freezers that they have in the processing plants are these blast freezers. They're negative 80 degrees, something ridiculous like that. That's going to actually preserve the quality of the flesh of this fish. Unlike our home freezer, which goes too slowly, where the water molecules break down and split and the fish becomes dry, which is why people are anti-frozen seafood. But now here's one of the great points of frozen seafood. And I serve frozen seafood in my restaurant. Not everything's frozen, but I do serve certain species that are frozen. I happen to like frozen mussels. Yes, frozen mussels. I know mussels are abundant pretty much year-round. You can buy Prince Edward Island black mussels. But the neat thing about the mussels, and I serve frozen softshell crabs as well, and even though that's a very seasonal item from the first full moon in May until September, people like to get fresh softshell crabs. I like to buy frozen. The neat thing about these types of seafood is that they actually harvest the seafood at its peak. So the mussels I get, that I receive year-round, are only harvested for a short time of the year. However, they're harvested at their peak time. They're always a plump mussel. They're never in their dormancy period. Same thing with softshell crabs. As soon as they shed, they harvest them, as opposed to packing them fresh, shipping them out, and 3-4 days later, the chef getting them, where there's a lot of dead softshell crabs, a lot of stinkers that you call in the box. So it's a way to actually get, same thing Sea to Table is saying, fresher than fresh. But the quality is always peak of this season. It's always when the quality is the most superb time of the year. So people rave about our mussels at my restaurant. They rave about them, and that's why, because they're being harvested at the peak time when the meat's the plumpiest, when the mussels are at the peak time of the year. Same thing with the softshell crabs. And of course, seasonal items like wild salmon, if you're getting it in the wintertime, it's always frozen because the wild salmon season is so short. For instance, we also use albacore tuna. Our albacore tuna is, the season's barely 6 weeks long in the Pacific Northwest. Barely 6 weeks, and we have it on our menu all year. It's sashimi grade. It's frozen within hours of catching it right on the boat. So the boat hasn't even come back to the dock yet, and it's processed and frozen on the boat. That makes a huge difference. So fresh versus frozen. People always say, well, is it fresh or is it frozen? I say, well, what's the opposite of fresh? And they always look at me and say, rotten. I said, perfect. The opposite of fresh is not frozen. Fresh and frozen can be the same outcome. And of course, in this case, frozen is fresher than fresh. So don't be turned off if you go to a restaurant or if you go to a retail outlet and you see things in a frozen section or the chef is boasting an out-of-season product like wild salmon in the middle of the winter. He's simply, hopefully, found a high-quality source of that product that you can enjoy year-round that's harvested in its peak season, peak quality. And so don't be afraid of frozen. I'm Chef Marcus Giuliano. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for tuning in. If you like my videos, please hit like, subscribe to my channel, and definitely pass it on.